Hi, my name is Bintu and I am going to explain you how to run your first JSP program in NetBeans IDE. NetBeans IDE is one of the wonderful IDEs available today where you can type, compile and run your Java programs. It might be JSP, JSF, EJBs at one place only. But the question is why JSP? The full form is JavaServer Pages. It was released by Sun Microsystems in 1999. It helps in creating dynamic web content. Static websites are the ones which gives you stable output. Whatever you click on, you'll get the same output every time. But when you say dynamic web content, means every web form will have some queries. You enter the query and accordingly it will give you an output. For example, if you click on cameras, it will show you the details of cameras. But when you click on something else, say washing machine, you'll get the output of washing machines. So dynamic web content means the form will take the queries of the user and accordingly it will give you the output. So with JSP, you can create dynamic web content. JSP can be easily mixed with HTML. HTML is one of the popular web developing languages, but it was insecure. So many web development technologies have erupted like ASP, JSP, PHP. So JSP can be mixed with HTML. Because JSP is Java based, so you can even utilize all the existing Java APIs, application programming interface, in your web app. So that will highly enhance your web applications. Before JSP, dynamic web pages were created in Java servlets, but the syntax of Java servlets was very hard, so it was a very hard time for the developers to work onto it. Indirectly, the JSP is an easier interface, and whatever code you write in JSP is basically internally converted to Java servlets only. So you are creating dynamic web pages through Java servlets only, but the interface has become very easy now. The syntax has become very easy. JSP separates your business logic from the presentation logic. In a website, there are two things. One is presentation, that is you make your website attractive through animations, through colors and cascading style sheets. Because the crude syntax, the logic of a site is your job now. Because JSP separates between the two. Presentation is not none of your developer's job now. You have to just focus on your business logic only. Presentation will be done by the web designer. The best part is that JSP not only includes Java code, it can use reusable Java classes also. We call it Java Beans. Java Bean that you've written for one application can be reused in another web applications also. Obviously, it helps you in establishing connection with the database. That means whatever the data is entered into your website will be stored into the database, and for that Java Bean will help you. Assessing and performing queries with the database is the job of Java Beans. So this is all. Now if I want to start with my first JSP program, what is the software that I require? First is your server. Obviously, whenever you upload any website, it has to be uploaded onto a server. The server should have two things. First thing, it should have a JSP engine. The code that you are writing is internally converted into a Java servlet. So it is a task of a JSP to convert your JSP code into Java servlets. It should have a technique to interact with the Java bean also. Your JSP code might interact with the Java bean. And as I told you, Java bean are reusable classes that helps in establishing connect with databases also. So one is you need a server where you will be uploading your web application. You need obviously Java, because unless you compile into servlets, it won't run. So second is your JDK. Third is your database. Database can be anything, MySQL or the popular RDBMS available today like Oracle or SQL Server of Microsoft. So these are the three things you require for running your JSP program. This is your first JSP program, and it will make you very clear that it is similar to your HTML. Basically, it's a HTML program only. See, it is printing your hello world in H1 heading 1 element. It is printing welcome to JSP in heading 2 element. This is a simple HTML program only. Before starting with the first program in NetBeans, you should remember something like this. First thing, it is similar to your HTML page. In this HTML page, you can type in your Java codes also. Body of the JSP is similar to your HTML body. It has HTML tags, it has a head, body and whatever. So this is that the JSP program appears as a HTML program, but you have to include Java codes to enhance it, to make it secure, to make it faster, to make it more efficient also. But how the JSP engine will know that this is the HTML code and this is the JSP code and I have to convert into Java subjects? The code which is enclosed between the less than sign and percentage and greater sign is the JSP code. And it is an indication to the JSP engine that this is the JSP code and please convert into Java subrets. So make it very clear that the code that is not enclosed between this will be considered as HTML code. The rest of things you know, JSP code is converted into Java subrets to make it efficient. Now this is the second program that I am explaining you in JSP. Here you are assigning a text hello world to MSG. Now, can you see that this JSP code is enclosed between this less than sign, percentage and greater than sign? So this is the indication to the JSP engine inside the server that please convert it into Java sublets. Here is a normal HTML code, as I have told you earlier also, that JSP code is similar to your HTML code. And what you are doing, that here you are recalling the variable MSG. This equal to sign is telling the JSP engine that I want the value of the MSG to be printed, MSG variable to be printed here. MSG variable assign hello world, so it will print hello world text and H1 element, heading 1 element, and welcome to JSP is a simple HTML code because it is not enclosed between these two symbols. Let's do it, the NetBeans IDE. I'm loading NetBeans IDE. It is a wonderful IDE, integrated development environment, that gives you a place to type, compile and run your JSP programs. So you'll get this first screen in NetBeans. You click on file, go to new project. Because you want to create a Java web application, click the Java web category, web application, and click on, this is the category of projects, and give the name as say first JSP app. Whatever name you give, and click on next. It is asking you what server that you want to use to run your JSP. With NetBeans you get two servers. While installing, it will ask you which one you want to install. You can install both. One is your Apache Tomcat and another is Glassfish. Apache is one of the wonderful server that we usually use for running your web applications. It is asking for the Java version that you want to use it. As I told you that Java is required and server is a prerequisite for running JSP codes. Let's click on next. It is asking you which framework you want to use for your web applications. Because I am using very simple web app, so I don't require any of these frameworks. But for sophisticated applications, I might require any of these frameworks. I'm given the four options: Spring, JSF, Struts, Hibernate, whatever. You simply don't select any of these options and click on finish. This is the code which is generated for you, auto-generated for you by NetBeans. And these are the files. It has created an index.html file for you with this default code. If you simply run it right now, it will give you the output to do write content. This is the code. You can see it's a simple HTML program with head tags, body tags. And you're not doing any changes into it. Just run it. See what is the output it is giving you. It is compiling. This is the browser it has opened. And it will give you the output. See, to do write content. So it has run this app on the local server, on local Tomcat Apache server. And I don't want this. Delete it. Let's delete it. Click on right click on index.html. And select delete. Now I want to add one JSP page to it. So on the web pages node, click on new, click on JSP option. Let's give the first name, say index. You are creating, you don't have to write the extension here, just index, and it will create a JSP page for you, index.jsp. Click on finish. So it is created again with the default content like this, and it is showing you that it will display the word hello world in H1 heading 1 element. Right, let's add one more. Well, JSP. Here you were supposed to close it. Close the heading 2 element. This is that. It's closed now. It is showing you the options anyway. You click on right click and click on run. This is output. Can you see that? So this was how you run your JSP program in NetBeans. Very simple. And if you got any problem, you do one thing, you can mail me at bmharmony@yahoo.com. Have a nice day. Thank you.